This country boy, he's a singing, singing when the sun goes down. He had all the answers about the way things ought to be. Some folks came to listen, some folks couldn't see that there's pain in his fingers, pain in his heart, trying to make a living, searching for a brand new start. Who needs some money that don't buy everything? Give everything he owns just for a chance to sing. He played all the honky-tonks, he played all the bars, he played all the one-night stands, trying to be a star. But when all the...
Yeah!
Yeehaw!
Come on, lady! Yeehaw!
Yeehaw!
Wow. What a motley crew we got here tonight. We don't know where our co-host went. She must have got caught in traffic somewhere.
Yeah.
Hopefully she'll be here later.
Right.
And everybody out there, you got to watch for a new show soon. You know the name of it, right? Our new show?
Weirdville.
Weirdville, USA.
Weirdville.
And it's weird.
And hey,
sounds
weird,
good.
Man,
huh? Sounds good.
Well, to see Phil get hit with a pie from his wife was great.
My own wife. Folks, my own wife hit me with a pie already. My own wife. Could you folks believe that?
Sometimes I wish I could have done that to George.
She asked if she could do it. I says, yeah, you're up. Batter up.
Right?
Yeah, right.
All right. Well, I know your mate passed away, George.
Yeah, a very loving man.
We're going to be playing some clips from you guys singing on the show. And
thank you.
He was a good guy. Quiet, but I'm sure he wasn't quiet when he was with you.
No. He was actually pretty quiet in general until he got a guitar in his hands. He used to be my square dance caller.
Oh, man, I didn't know that. I could have got him a job now.
He would put a guitar in his hands and he'd be ready to go.
Wow.
Yeah, that's pretty good. He learned from my dad. My dad was a square dance caller.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, you know, square dancing was a big, big thing back in the 50s.
Yep. Yeah. Yep. I grew up around it.
My dad and them used to go. They used to have them in people's basements or anywhere.
Yep.
Anywhere they could have
it. We've done shows for people like that.
Little moonshine and away we go.
Was that before line dancing?
Hell yeah.
Oh, yeah. Line dancing didn't get
line dancing sort of turned into... the middle income people who could afford the belts, the pants, the boots, and change every week. Every week they try to outdo each other. Look at my boots.
Right?
They spend thousands of dollars.
Right? Square dancing you learn from the time you're a kid.
Well, we used to have cloggers.
Yeah.
I've had cloggers on here.
I tried learning how to do that. My brain knew what it was supposed to do, but my feet didn't want to cooperate.
That is not easy.
No, it is not. It is not.
One of my friends who was a clogger, she works over in Walmart, and she says, I really like to get back to it, but I don't think my legs could handle it.
Yeah, it takes a lot on your legs.
It's all legs. Line dancing's sort of the same way. You don't use this part of your body up.
Right.
It's just steps and stuff, and... the one lady actually took one of my songs and made a dance out of it.
Yeah, I saw that on Facebook.
Honky Tonk Stomper.
Yep, I saw that.
And,
pretty cool.
So, yeah, she did a good job of it. She has a big dance group, too.
That's good. Yeah, I saw quite a few of them there. I was doing that.
Phil could probably do that. He looks like a stomper.
Yeah.
And today it's my former Scott Max's wife that is the DJ for Night Dancing.
Yeah?
Yeah, she's the one who took your song.
What's her name?
I know her last name is Gil. I don't remember her first name.
Gil. That's her last name, Gil.
Yeah.
And they're related to you?
No, she's my former scoutmaster.
Oh, she's a scoutmaster too?
Her husband was.
Wow.
Okay.
And I asked her if she could make a dance out of that, and they practiced it and did it. I keep plugging it all the time on Facebook.
Yeah, it's good.
Oh, yeah.
It's good. Yeah, I've forwarded it a couple of times to different people.
Well, I drive everybody nuts because I keep posting all kinds of crazy stuff. You know, it's...
I'm used to it.
Right?
Well, in the beginning it was, if I send it to you, they would get it.
Right.
Then I'd send it to him, you'd get it again.
Right.
And I send it to him, you got it again. So if I send it to 30 people, you get it 30 times.
Right. And then I send it on, you know.
But I don't care.
Right.
It's all promotion.
Of course.
And people who know me don't care. They want to go out and have a good time. You know, and we got a lot of things coming up down here. We're going to have a hot dog eating contest.
Oh, wow.
Right here at the station.
Uh-huh.
Phil's going to be involved with that. He could probably eat a lot of them hot dogs.
Right.
And it's going to be a table. It costs you like a donation of $25 to if you want to be in the contest. And then $5 at the door to get in and watch these people eating these hot dogs.
Oh, my God.
Well, we got to learn ways of making money here at the station.
Yeah, pie eating contests are too.
What's that?
Pie eating contests.
We could do all that stuff.
Well, yeah. In Coney Island, you know, every 4th of July they have that championship hot dog.
Right. Yeah, I've seen that on TV. Yeah.
Right.
And what's funny about it is you ever notice it's the tiny little people that win it.
Right. Right. You have to practically starve yourself all day.
No, they do just the opposite. They eat and stretch their stomach.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Real big before they eat. Yeah, and then they can eat more.
Huh.
So you could do it. Just keep eating pastrami. I can't even say it.
Pastrami. Pastrami.
All right, everybody out there. And I got to say hi to Bullville.
Hey, Bullville.
Benzie,
Bullville.
I don't know when he's ever coming back. And
he's
Pam,
on the
too.
Roof.
Pam's busy working. So that bunch, I don't know when they're coming back. But tonight... We got this beautiful lady here co-hosting with us.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Took some time out of her life, and she just lost her husband, who was a good musician. You know, and everybody out there, you got to support all the musicians.
Yes, you do.
And book them and hire them and actually pay them. Don't always have to freebies. And if you're in a band, don't let certain people put your name down without you knowing it.
I don't know anybody that would do that.
Yeah, like they go, hey, Phil, we're going to have a big shindig. And then you look at it, you go, well, how come my name's on there?
Yeah, right.
He's not going to let me live that one down.
And then I thought it was, I had it mixed up because I thought it was at their church. But actually, that was something different. Because she said, you don't need a guitar, come on in. I'm going, what?
Right.
So I went in and they sang my song, which was beautiful. 100 people sang it. It was.
Yeah, we, you know, we've been working on your song. I kind of changed the words around a little bit.
Yeah, I listened to it. Yeah.
No, I haven't done that one yet.
No, you didn't record it, but I seen you doing it at your daughter's house. After the services and all that, whenever whoever's house you was at, you was singing in the kitchen or something.
Oh, yeah, that was my sister's house.
Right.
That was my sister's house. Oh, yeah, that's right. It was on Facebook. That's right.
Boy. These seniors are terrible.
I get CRS all the time.
What house?
I get CRS all the time.
What are you?
I'm just old. I have brain farts where I can't remember. I can't remember a few words, but I've seen Phil do that too.
Actually, my fiddle player, he has a song called Brain Farts.
Wow.
He gets a little rowdy once in a while.
Well, he said he might help me out here and there and set in. Because my poor fiddle player, God bless her, has got leukemia.
Oh.
And she can't play this year either.
Aww.
She couldn't play last
year.
She's
such a nice lady.
That is such a battle. And it's like, I just got her. She's always been a great fiddle player, but I just got her to playing my style.
Right.
And we all miss her. I hope she can make it back.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
That's a dread disease.
Right, that's for sure. That's for sure. Cancer is, any kind of form of cancer is.
Well, it seems like up in your area, in Ellenville and everything, they all got some kind of cancer up there. It's terrible.
Well, you know, kind of a weird area.
What are they putting in the water up there?
I don't know, but there's a few issues they got going on up there because of the plants up there. I mean the plants like Channel Masters and BAW and stuff like that. They got some issues.
Well, this week, my wife just had double
skin cancer surgery on her face, and she has to have more major surgery.
Oh, wow. I'll be with her.
Leg, and they did a biopsy on the other leg. We hope it's not, but we're waiting for that to come back.
Yeah. Skin cancer's really tricky.
Yeah.
Lois's grandfather had that, too.
Yeah, I had cancers a couple years ago in my lymph nodes, and I thought it was all gone, and now it's starting to come back again.
Oh, boy.
So,
man, sit closer to Nick.
No, I don't want any bad luck.
Listen, I got to tell you, I didn't bring it. I don't know why. I didn't bring the hot dogs over. My sponsor is Roy's Corner at Homer's.
Yeah, I've had his hot dogs. Yeah. They're really, really good.
And they got that smoker going now. You can get smoked ribs and stuff. And even Phil can go down there and eat. Because they don't have, what is it? What do you call it?
Kosher?
Gluten-free
stuff, too. And now he can go down there and eat, you know, some pork and stuff.
I don't know about that. You're going to get me in trouble, Rabbi.
Listen, Rabbi, this guy eats pork. Don't let him say, he ate 40 hot dogs here one day, and I had to warn him later that was all pork dogs. So he had to be forgiven.
You can't eat turkey dogs either?
Turkey dogs, yes. I'm good with that.
I hate all them. It's got to be beef. I don't want them.
My wife used to get those turkey dogs.
But we got Texas wieners here waiting for us.
Here we go.
Yes.
And we're going to enjoy them. We want to get moving along. We want to get Phil up to sing. So go over there and hide.
Okay.
This guy's a character of his own. He's the real Mr. Phil. There is only one of them. Just like Tiny Tim told me when he sang some songs of mine, I'm the real Tiny Tim.
Real
Mr. I remember him.
All right, I'm going to come over and get the cameras on you. Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Huh?
There's no camera on.
No camera on? Well, you can't crack that camera. And don't worry, everybody. Spring is really coming, and get out and listen to all the bands and the music. Support us, local people. We need it. Don't worry about Nick. He can't buck anybody.
Of course he could.
Okay.
Now put your heart into it, Phil, like you really, like you really want it.
Special song now. I'm doing this for you, Pat. And so in the memory of George. Just everybody out there, all of our fans and viewers from both shows, actually all three shows from KCS, from Weird Bill and Mr. Phil show. This is a very special show song in memory of.
Well, hang on for a minute, because some reason your camera's like a crack.
The lens off?
No. Mr. Phil, he really did something to it.
Something's not plugged in, I guess.
There you go.
It helps when it's plugged in.
You're in there, Phil.
Okay. Very good.
Sing it with all your heart.
Okay, thank you. The song is called Angels Among Us. I was walking home from school on a cold winter day. Took a shortcut through the woods, found I lost my way. I was getting kinda late, I was scared and all alone. But that kind old man from nowhere took my hand and led me home. Mama didn't see him, oh, but he was standing there. And I knew in my heart he was an answer to my prayer. Oh, I believe there are angels among us. Us from somewhere up above, they come to you and me in our darkest hour to show us how to live and teach us how to give and guide us when troubled times, life had me down on my knees. There's always been someone who'd come along and comfort me. A kind word from a stranger who could lend a helping hand, or a phone call from a friend just to say I understand. Now ain't it kind of funny how at the dark end of your road it seems someone likes your way with just a single ray of hope. Oh, I believe there are angels among us sent out to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hour to show us how to live and teach us how to give and guide us with a light of love. They wear so many faces, show up in the strangest places to grace us with their mercies and our cries of need. Oh, I believe there are angels among us sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hour to show us just how to give and guide us with the light of love. They guide us with the light of love. Thank you. That's for you, George. I got another one for you. I remember Daddy's hands folded silently in prayer and reaching out to hold me when I had a nightmare. You could read quite a story in the calluses and lines. Years of work and worry have left their mark behind. I remember Daddy's hands, how they held my mama tight and patted my back for something done right. There are things that I've forgotten that I love about the man, but I'll always remember the love in Daddy's hand.
Daddy's hand, soft and kind when I was crying. Daddy's hand, hardest tear when I done wrong.
Daddy's hands weren't always gentle, but I've come to understand there was always love in Daddy's hands. I remember Daddy's hands working until they bled, sacrificed unselfishly just to keep us all fed. If I could do things over and live my life again, I'd never take for granted the love in Daddy's hands.
Daddy's hands, soft and kind when I was blind. Daddy's hands were hardest steel when I done wrong.
Daddy's hands weren't always gentle, but I've come to understand
there was always love in Daddy's
hand. Daddy's
hand, soft and kind, and I was crying. Daddy's hand,
what hard is it when I done wrong? Daddy's hands weren't always gentle, but I've come to understand
there was always love
in Daddy's hands. Thank you.
Thank you, folks.
Well, come on over, George. I'm calling him George. George is watching you.
Yes.
He's probably laughing like her and me. He's laughing her ass off here. Hey, look what I found. You can't eat these.
Oh.
Well, they got gluten.
Yeah, okay, have fun.
These are Texas wieners, right from up to Roy's.
Yep.
We're up there almost every day, and I get clam chowder. That's my favorite. And
Texas wieners from Port Jervis, New York.
Right? That's right.
They're really good.
Yeah.
The best.
Yeah.
So you can talk to her while I get another bite.
Okay.
I thank you very much for doing those songs for George. I really appreciate it. Thank you.
Right. And, folks, there's a saying, the show must go on, no matter what. Quite a while ago, I booked George and Pat for my Memorial Day weekend show, May 26th. And that's always a big show because that's the kickoff to summer. So, unfortunately, George passed away, but the show will go on, and it'll go on with Pat, and we're bringing special guest Josie Lou down to that show.
Wow. I think my boys will be here, for at least one of them will be.
Right.
Probably my fiddle player.
Yeah, that'll be great. So it'll, you know, be.
When is that? Not tomorrow night. It's the next week.
No, it's 2 weeks.
2 weeks.
3 weeks.
3 weeks.
3 weeks.
Memorial Day weekend.
I don't listen to you ever again. She said 2 weeks.
Yeah. And, you know, we'd love you to come down to it.
Her or me?
You. She's coming.
Oh, she'll be there, right?
Yeah, you gotta come. Yeah, we want you to come. You know.
Well. You know, our musicians, when they pass, we got to have a tribute to them. And I try to do that with everybody on my show and do tributes. Because I got a lot of the people you know on tape here.
Right.
And we promote everybody all over. And I got a shout out to Manhattan, MNN. I've been on there, I don't know how many years now. What's it been, 5 or 6 years?
It's 5 years for us, MNN.
And we're all over Manhattan. And if you like a hillbilly boy like me, keep tuning in and let him know and tell him you want to see more.
And that's, I brought this boy into Brooklyn, too.
Yeah, and I'm in Brooklyn, too. So
on Brick TV.
We're on YouTube. We're all over the place. And I'm going to Nashville sometime in August.
Great.
And I got to thank some lady, a friend of mine. I don't want to mention names, but she gave me her Winnebago.
That's awesome. Wow. That's totally awesome.
It needs to be repaired a little bit, but she gave it to me for free.
That's awesome.
And, it reminds me of the old days when people used to help each other.
Yeah.
Right?
Of course.
Yeah.
And that's what I always liked about these guys. Even if they did get the dates wrong with me, they was always there for their church and their community. That's
right.
The way it used to be.
Yes.
Here, now, we got this coming. Tell us what it's all about, can you?
My fiddle player is the MC of this, and he's been doing this for, oh, God, at least 10, 15 years. We've been playing up at the old-time fiddlers for about 7 years. And it's just a bunch of people that come up, and it's all acoustic. Most of it is acoustic. Mm-hmm. There's a couple things that are electric. But I'll be there with my boys, Bob Hunt and Paul Lansbury. And it's open to everybody. It's like $10 for adults and $1 for students, and kids under 3 are free. So,
great.
And
That's great.
To support the pregnancy program in Liberty, New York. Mm-hmm. So we just enjoy getting together.
It's a great cause, too.
Yep. Yeah, it is. So we help them out, and we get a chance to see old friends and have a good time.
And we're going to be doing the food bank, Rockin' the City for Hunger. Okay. I'm going to think that's August. Is it September or August?
It's usually September.
September 16th?
Yeah, something like that.
Something like that. So Everybody come out. You got to bring canned goods. We got ShopRite on board. It's going to help us with this. And we got some of the farmers from Pine Island who are on it. And we just get some entertainers come down and sing a little bit, play a little bit. And maybe we'll have some hot dogs down there and donate some food, because we're trying to help the food banks in the area who are always in need.
Yeah.
You're always helping this community out. Every time I turn around, you're doing something wonderful for this community. I hope they know how appreciative they are.
Well, I say God gives you a gift, and my mother used to say you're very talented, but you got to make sure you give back.
We use it in the right way. Yep.
And I believe in that.
Of course.
Speaking of charity, I'll be performing with Mary Frost, my partner, at the Relay for Life, the cancer benefit walk in Goshen, New York, the Goshen High School, on Saturday night, June 10th at 8 o'clock p.m.
Wow.
Nice.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Nice.
Even speaking of June 10th, all of you know from becoming more than I am now, I just became an evangelist. I'm doing a crusade. I found out recently 500,000 people since Vietnam has died from heroin overdose. And I'm gonna
It's bad anyway.
Gonna be doing the purpose of becoming more than I know, which why I'm dead here, is to save lives of 500,000 people, especially in the Fort Terrace area.
All right, well, listen, we got to go. Right now, we got some video of Pat and her husband playing down here on our station, and they're always welcome here. She's always welcome, and I still say he's here.
Yep.
And he's
on his side, the Lord is on his side.
He just whispered to me, she's still out of key. I said, well, I don't know, it's out of tune. Yeah. So.
He's a wonderful
man. But that's
man.
Okay. You're out of tune. He's out of key. It's a perfect match in heaven. But he's up in heaven. He does have. I seen him smile before.
Yeah.
All right. Let's go to that video as a little tribute here.
Okay.
Country Travelers.
Hey. This is an original song that I just got done writing in May. I found some old love letters you wrote a long time ago. You said that I was yours alone and you wanted our love to grow. All those things do happen and we went our separate ways. I've never stopped loving you. Even still today, my heart was still with you, and I wondered if you loved me too. Now my heart still aches at the thought of seeing you. I wanted so much to work it out without being down, and I'd love. Well, I went down to the bar in town to have a drink or two. When I saw you standing there and my memories went back to you. We've had our troubles, our ups and downs, and I'd love to have a chance with you for a second time around. Thank you. I hear people talking bad about the way they have to live here in this country, harping on the wars we fight and rapping about the things we ought to be. Well, I don't mind them switching sides and standing up for things that they believe in, but when they're running down our country, man, they're walking on the fight. Side of me. Yeah, they're walking on the fighting side of me. Running down our way of life, our fighting men have fought and died to keep. Well, if you don't love it, leave it. Let this song that I'm singing be a warning. If you're running down, well, I read about some squirrely guy who claims that he just don't believe in fighting. And I wonder just how long the rest of us can count on being free. Well, they love our milk and honey, but they preach about some other way of living. When you're running down our country, man, you're walking on. Running down our way of life, our fighting men have fought and died to keep. Well, if you don't love it, leave it. Let this song that I'm singing be a warning. If you're running down our country, man, you're walking on the back side of me. If you're running down. This is another one of my songs that I just wrote. QG. The country songs of today, yeah, there are some stories too. There's more of a beat than how they tell how people really feel. Well, I love the old style country music and love the heart so true. Even songs of Jesus, because we know he's real. Well, I love country music, yes, way down in my soul. I love to hear those old life songs and that train that's coming soon. Well, the old time songs sing about Jesus and when he calls the roll. Yeah, what they got in common is those good old gospel tunes. When Johnny and June start singing their sweet songs of love, Kenny and Loretta sang to Jesus, you know you can't go wrong. The room was filled with love sent down from heaven above to hear Roy and Charlie fill the room with their powerful love. Well, I love country music, yes, way down in my soul. I love to hear those old life songs and that train that's coming soon. Well, the old-time songs sing about Jesus and when he calls the roll. They walk the God and come in his old good old gospel tunes. Good old country music was sang at the Grand Ole Opry. When they sang around the hearse, melted to the Lord. Boy, you know the Grand Ole Opry was a mother church of country songs. Yes, country gospel music were married and blessed upon every word. Yeah, I love country music, yes, way down in my soul. I love to hear those old life songs and that train that's coming soon. Well, the old time songs sing about Jesus and when he calls the roll. Yeah, what they got in common is those good old gospel tunes. Yeah, what they got in common is those good old gospel tunes.
Yes.
Now, I've heard people say the old country's hokey, That's real country. That's American. That's real country. Mm-hmm. And without that, you wouldn't have none of this stuff today. A lot of younger people want to play it hard, fast. Elvis's songs had a groove. He didn't have to play it real loud or real fast. It was a groove. And all them artists to make you dance.
That's right. That's for sure.
Well, Carl, did you know that Elvis could have actually been in country music?
Well,
in the direction he was going, he could have been in country music.
Yeah.
So another one I'm going to surprise you with, Buddy Holly.
Yeah.
They wanted him in country music. All those ones that
like
started
a changeover.
That
like,
time.
Well, the Everly Brothers too.
Right.
They wanted them in country.
Oh.
There's a whole slew of them, and they all ended up playing sort of country in the end.
Yep.
Yeah.
Country with country music, it's more like every song tells some sort of a story. A real story.
Hank Williams wrote so many songs. I heard Willie Nelson sing Blue Eyes Crying in the Rain. I said, I've heard that before. So I went on YouTube, got Hank Williams Sr. Hank Williams Sr. wrote that and sang it before Willie ever did anything.
Yeah. Yeah. Willie has his own style of doing certain
Hank
things.
Hank knew a way to deliver the song.
Right.
And you
exactly.
Listen,
he was a performer.
His son's good, but he ain't as good as his dad, I don't think.
No, I don't either.
Grandson's okay, but none of them are as good as the grandfather.
Right.
He just had a way to, the feeling in his voice.
Yep.
And he had so many songs for a young guy. He wasn't old.
No. He was very young.
Well, I had a movie about him, his life, and they said he was taking horse pills for painkillers. That's what killed him.
Hmm.
It wasn't drugs and stuff. He had a bad back, so they gave him.
Right.
He thought this doctor was giving him painkillers. He was. But they were horse pills. They weren't even. He wasn't even a doctor.
Yeah.
But they affect the human different, and it screwed his heart up.
Wow.
Killed him.
Wow.
So. But I did get to meet his daughter, Jet Williams.
Yeah.
We were right in her dressing room and everything, me and Lois, and I actually booked her for the Orange County Fair. And
that's cool.
They were sweetheart people. Very polite and stuff like that, and it was a good show.
A lot of the old-time country people, they're really down to earth.
Yes, they are.
They're really down to earth. Some of these other ones, they're okay.
Well, I see it on Facebook. My uncle played with the Phelps brothers, and somebody's out there is pushing the Phelps brothers. It's not a reunion. It's every year they have a big, giant picnic down south in Virginia, and they have like a big barbecue, and they have it's the Phelps Brothers picnic or something.
Uh-huh. That's nice.
And I said something about my uncle, and they all knew him.
That's good.
He was well known in the field.
Right. But it's nice to have family history like that.
Yeah.
You know, runs it called running in the jeans, you know, with the music.
Yeah, I run in my jeans every day. But don't wear them on Planet Fitness. They don't let you have jeans. That's what you need, Planet Fitness. You lose some of that big gut you got. What do you mean?
That's meaning all that kosher
all
food. Yeah.
What do you mean? You know I go to the gym. I go on a treadmill 40
minutes. Go to Jim's house and have a bottle of beer. You know. You go to a gym?
Yeah, in my development we have one.
I don't know if that's the same kind of thing.
Yeah. 40 minutes.
Well, I won't bring up the pool when you go there. The rabbi knew what he does. He'd never be forgiven, sir. I forgive him myself.
Yeah. He wants to come on your show, too.
Bring him on. I'd love to meet him.
Yeah.
We could say, I could straighten him out, would you?
He's a musician. He plays trumpet.
Oh, nice.
Well, that'd fit in here.
That'd lighten things up.
Yeah.
Yeah, he could.
Does he play horn, the ramp horn, too?
He plays a few things. He's really good, you know. That's not his only one.
What I heard is he wants to get a marker, too. Now, I don't know what that meant. But when he sees this, Phil told me to say that. There's a lot of things going on all through the area, a lot of parties, and we're going to be playing in the Riverside Park sometime in the summer, little concert series, Rich Wilson and Al's Music with the Irish band. They're going to be there one day. We're there one day.
Wow.
That's cool.
On like a Thursday night. Yeah. So it's... and then we have over in the Matamoros, we have Tuesday nights in the park.
Mm-hmm.
And we got a bunch of different bands coming there from like 7 to 9.
Nice.
And everybody come out with your lawn chairs, no charge to get in.
Nice.
All kinds of music, come over and listen to it. So, it should be jumping. Don't start yawning.
I'm sorry.
Oh, man.
I tried.
Had a busy day.
It came from you, Nick.
Yeah, I did.
Had a busy day.
You know, the the country that they play today, you can't tell if it's pop or not.
Yeah, it's like...
All right, we're going to play some more right now of you and George.
Okay.
And we really, really, really like the guy, and he loved music.
I really appreciate this, Pearl. It means a lot to me. Thank
That's
you.
That's okay. Just don't book me without me knowing. Anyway. How long is this one, hon? We don't know, but it's coming on shortly.
This is another song that I wrote.
There you go, another one you wrote. I gotta go.
Many years ago, you came into my life. I didn't know there could be someone that would take me for his wife. I wanted someone who would always be true. God sent me an angel, and that someone was you. God sent me an angel from heaven long ago. He sent lose his lonesome blues. somebody new. Well, I told him everything from A to Z. Oh, lonesome me. Well, I bet he's not like me. He's out fancy free, flirting with the girls with all his charm. Watch on his heart and mind. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep pins out for the tie they bind. Because you're mine, I walk the line. I find it very, very easy to be true. I find myself alone when each day's through. Yes, I'll admit that I'm a fool for you. Because you're mine, I walk the line. As sure as night is dark and day is light, I keep you on my mind both day and night. And happiness I've known proves that it's right. Because you're mine, I walk the line. You got a way to keep me on your mind. You give me a cause for love that I can't hide. For you I know I'd even try to turn the tide. Because you're mine, I walk the line. I keep a close watch on the heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. Keep the ends out for the tie that binds. Because you're mine, I walk the line. Because you're mine, I walk the line. Thank you.
Yeah.
She's walking the line, that woman.
Walking the line. What are you doing, Pat? Get up on the rope and walk?
Man, I'm telling you. We just got to say a salute to George.
Yeah.
He's a good guy, and for what I know him for, he was really a good family man. So I went to the service, which you two bums never showed up.
Sorry, buddy.
Don't be sorry to me. This lady was worth showing up for. So we're going to get up, and are we almost ready for that? We're going to get up and sing a song, and we're going to dedicate it to George, you and me.
Yep.
And he'll probably laugh at both of us anyways. So we're going to do this Hank Williams song and see how it goes.
Here we go.
So you guys sit here and relax.
Yeah. All right.
Talk a little bit.
All right.
You can lower it. Is that off again? Keep talking. You're on the air.
Yeah. These people are showstoppers. You realize you got the two most talented people up there in the area. You realize that?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah.
Well, I know. I don't know about Pat.
The karaoke there or there?
Right here, here's the words.
Yeah, of course.
Wow. So you're gonna like Don't it. Laugh, George.
If you want to have fun, come along with me.
Hey, 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 good looking. What you got cooking? How's about cooking something up with me? Check it out, Butterball. That's for George up there.
God bless you, honey.
He's laughing at us, too.
Probably cracking up. Yeah, he's probably cracking up.